Hi, what if you want to generate a quote and send it automatically through email through your primary contact? In this opportunity, we have a primary contact called Jack Rogers, and we want to send him the quote automatically. So instead of clicking the button, downloading the quote, opening it, sending it by email, we will now just see how easy it is with PDF Builder to auto-send this quote. First step is to make sure you have an organization-wide address to send from. So in this case, it's called info. We will create a template. So a classic email template that will not be demonstrated in this video. There are lots of videos out there that already show how to create an email template. So I have my email template. I have my organization-wide address. Now I need a query to make sure that I have the right contact person. So take a look at this query. You can just normally copy-paste it and reuse it. So it will select a contact in this case. And which contact to select? Select the primary contact from the opportunity contract roles. So you can generate your own query here, or if you use the same way as we do here, you can just use the opportunity contact role and use the primary contact in that one. Okay, so we have everything set up. Next step is to create a PDF Builder pack. A pack is actually just grouping together certain doc configs, actions that you want to do, and we call the pack here mail quote. Of course, the quote, the doc config we want to generate is the quote doc config. Make sure it's active. I save the quote. Okay, now we have a pack, but of course there is no actions defined on the pack. So let's go to the related section here. We go to actionables, new. Auto email. So there is another movie for email.config. That's when you want to create an email through a .config. But in this case, we have generated the email from a classic template in Salesforce. So we select auto email. Next, actionable name. Let's call it actionable underscore auto email. Okay. The .config is not required. It's automatically already linked to the pack. It's after, so this means when do you have to run this action? After the document is generated, make sure it's active. The email template name, okay, let's copy paste that one. Very often mistakes are made here, so don't copy the email template name, but copy the unique name. So YouTube demo in this case. The org while email address, that's the name of the email address. So you saw that I called it info. And then the data source to select the primary contact. In this case, primary contact data source. If you want to send to more contacts and other persons as well, then of course, these can also be selected. You can send it to a lot of other persons. Just create a query as a data source and that's it. Okay, next step, we save this. And actually the entire configuration to auto email your quote is done. So copy this ID because it will be required to finalize the configuration. Go to the opportunity, edit the page. On the opportunity page, we will add a new .config component. So just add it here. Okay, we don't need a locale, we don't need the alternative, we don't need to allow data files to get uploaded, we don't want to download our file anymore, no preview, the pack ID, I just copied that, so I'll paste it here, the name of the pack, we'll call mail quote for instance, so everything is done, save, changes are saved, I go back. And when I click this button, PDF, then automatically my quote will be generated and sent to the email recipients. So see how fast that went? And I already got a ping on my cell phone and I also got a ping here. So my quote arrived. and you will see that it's actually the entire quote that I expected. So nice header quote, nice picture, all the information. Dear Jack, that's a personalization, that's the user that sent it, and of course my quotes attached as a PDF. That's how easy it is to send a quote or a document via PDF Butler packs and actionables. So if you have more questions, just call out to info or service at pdfbutler.com. Thanks.